Thank you for joining us for today's CITI program webinar. Today's topic is Getting Started in Grant Writing, an introduction for graduate students, postdocs, and new faculty. Now, let me tell you about today's presenter. Dr. Devino is Executive Director of Sponsored Programs at the University of Houston, Clear Lake. She holds a PhD in chemistry and served as a faculty member at 2- and 4-year colleges before transitioning into full-time research development and administration. And now I'm going to pass the mic to you, Nancy.
Thank you, Jamie. The learning objectives for today's webinar include identifying major phases in grant proposal development, locating relevant sources of information on funding opportunities, summarizing information found in a request for proposals, and outlining the steps to go from proposal concept to proposal submission. We'll address each of these objectives in the 4 sections of today's webinar. We'll begin with phases of proposal development, moving into then funding opportunity searches, analysis of a request for proposals using an actual example, and finally, looking into more details about proposal preparation and submission. I like to think of proposal preparation as consisting of 6 different phases. Some of those, though, include the review phase at the end after a proposal is submitted to a funding agency. The total elapsed time from idea to funding decision can be as long as 10 to 14 months. The first phase in proposal preparation is idea development. Before we even go into that, I want to be really clear about what a grant is and what it is not. A grant is not free money. A grant is money that is given by a funding agency to advance its goals and objectives. In return for that money, you carry out specific activities that respond to those goals and objectives. So even as you're developing an idea, it needs to be focused on what a funding agency might be interested in, less so on what you are personally interested in. The idea development can take a month or longer, and it centers on a problem statement or statement of need. The grant funding provides the resources to implement the solutions to those problems. It really involves a thorough knowledge of what has already been done. How is or are the existing knowledge and practices and resources adequate or inadequate? And how is your idea new, unique, or better? This last point is quite important because agencies like to fund innovative ideas. They don't fund the status quo. There are really 3 strategies for finding funding. One of them is a database search, where you might look for all kinds of grants or look only for federal grants. The key source for federal grants is grants.gov. We'll look at that in detail in just a few minutes. Another source for searching for funding opportunities are subscription services, and your institution may have one or more of these available for you. Another way to find grant funding is to explore the grants or funding pages on agency or organization websites of interest that are relevant to the idea you would like to explore. You can also look for email alerts that come from professional societies. You might register for alerts on a search site, or you can register on an agency site. Let's summarize the 4 key takeaways from today's webinar. First, grant proposal writing takes time. It can take 10 to 14 months. It can be done sooner, but that's an ideal for allowing sufficient time for the ideas and for the proposal planning and writing. Finding funding opportunities requires effort. Following the RFP guidelines is critical to success. And finally, though, despite those 3 hardships, the effort will pay off in personal satisfaction and career success when a grant gets awarded.
Thank you, Nancy. We now have a little bit of time for the few questions that we received from the audience. So the first question, what kind of organization affiliation do you need as a minimum to apply for NIH grants?
Oh, great question, Jamie. All kinds of organizations are eligible to apply for NIH grants, colleges, universities, hospitals, medical research institutions, and more. As long as you personally are affiliated with an organization that is registered in the systems that are needed to submit NIH grants, such as grants.gov and the NIH ERA Commons system, you may be able to apply for NIH grants if you meet your organization's eligibility requirements.